9 months before the criminal invasion of Iraq. By the way, Saddam Hussein was our anti-communist ally. You know, we propped him up, urged him to invade Iran, 500,000 dead Iranians, gave him equipment, gave him the materials that he made chemical warfare with. So when we invaded Iraq, Bush and Cheney, 9 months, 6 months, 3 months, I counted 300 retired generals, admirals, retired national security officials, and diplomats all spoke out again and again against this criminal war that was pending. They were people like Admiral Shanahan, retired, former head of the Pacific Fleet. They were Marine General Anthony Zinni, Middle East expert, against the war, warned against it. Said most people in the U.S. Army and the Pentagon agreed with him, but they were Muslim. Imagine that. Most people in the U.S. Army opposed Bush-Cheney, but they were Muslim. Then there was James Baker, Brent Scowcroft, the two key national security aides to George W. Bush's father, George Herbert Walker Bush. They had op-eds. Don't invade Iraq. It's going to be a disaster. Then we had the four-star general, head of the National Security Agency, Howard Odom. This is going to be the biggest blunder in American history. Don't do it. And then the mass media ignored them. They had no secretariat, no infrastructure, no full-time people getting them on the media, mobilizing them, going them to 600, 800, 1,200, 1,500, unstoppable. George Soros opposed the war. He opposed it publicly. He opposed it repeatedly. Somehow, he didn't put $100 or $200 million to back up those 300 retired diplomats, national security specialists, and military admirals and generals. Had he done that, we would have got him up to Congress, the media would have been challenged, and the lies of Bush and Cheney about weapons of mass destruction held by Saddam Hussein, about Saddam Hussein sending drones over the Atlantic, all the lies would have been exposed. When you go on national TV and you're a four-star general in the Marines and you're head of the National Security Agency and you call them out on national TV backed by this secretariat, you think Bush and Cheney wouldn't melt it away with their lies? We could have stopped the war, stopped the consequences, stopped the trillions of dollars, stopped the spread of violence and chaos, stopped the spread of what is coming to this country, not only in destroying our tax base and budgets, not only destroying the soldiers who come back from over there, it's coming here because we're training and expanding our opponents over there. We got to get out of their backyard. We got to stop propping dictatorships up that slice them up in oppression with U.S. tax dollars and U.S. military. And that doesn't just go for the Arab governments, it goes for the Israeli military juggernaut as well. One of the best spectacles you'll ever see are Israelis and Palestinians in nonviolent demonstrations on the West Bank Israeli border. That is a perfect symbol up against the soldiers and the batons and everything, locking in arms as they do with unified humanity. That's what counts, that kind of moral courage. My last request is this. I brought this book called The Crimes of War. It's 30 people who specialize in wars that violate international law, Geneva Conventions, U.S. Constitution, federal statutes. Cindy Sheehan is in this book. Howard Zinn is in this book. Richard Falk is in this book. You gotta go away with this guidebook. This is a book that will convince your friends and relatives who are serious, co-workers, neighbors. This is the book for the discussion in the living rooms to create the small communities that will be networked to triumph. To triumph. Let us not, our generation, be viewed by successive generations as unwilling to exert a little effort in order to achieve a great peace. They're down there on the table. I hope you'll pick them up. And I hope when you go back home, you will double, triple your numbers and see each of you as your own epicenter of activity. And say to your friends and neighbors, there's always time for fun, there's always time for entertainment, but if we don't provide serious time to shape the future of our country and its influence around the world,
talk about Bernie!
Nor entertainment, nor reason to raise our family. Thank you very much.
No, Ralph!
Yeah, well, time. But it's not a